H. Eugene is the author of books Speaking With My Lips Sealed, Unforgettable Thriller, The Trifecta, God Will Never Forget This Day, Psychological Thrillers, Cereal, No Milk, The Ugly Bomb, and 13 Flowers. His latest release, Linda's Closet, will shake you to the core. He is a resident of Detroit where he plots the points of his next smash creation. Tracee Boyd crashed into the literary scene in 2012. Her books quickly caught attention of readers with the realistic storylines, as well as her ability to shock her readers with different plot twists when you would never see it coming. Tracee has been called the plot twist queen, and if you've read any of her books, you'll see that she's deserving of the nickname. In her spare time, she enjoys writing, cooking, blogging, shopping for sexy shoes, and spending time with her two kids and loved ones. Tracee is a great combination of sweet and sassy, and it spills over into her storytelling. Her novels will snatch you in and take you on a wild ride of reality and unexpected events. She has written 6 novels, including 2 urban fiction bestsellers. Signed to Royalty Publishing, Tracee intends to deliver some great stories that will make you cry, laugh out loud, and say to yourself, how does she come up with this stuff? Her most recent book, Hard-Headed in Love, Your Husband, Our Man 1 and 2, Beautifully Damaged and Disloyal, are available on Amazon. Tracee currently lives in Southfield, Michigan, where she works in human resources.
Welcome to the Conversations with Kai Mann show. I'm your host, Kai Mann, and this is the show where we bridge the gaps one story at a time. And today we have the dynamic duo here, who is H. Eugene and Tracee Boyd. They are here to talk books, life, and how to be a dynamic duo. How are you guys doing?
We're great. Thank you. Wonderful.
Yeah. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you for having us.
I am glad that you guys came on the show. I've been kind of like watching you guys for a minute. I know that you guys have this dynamic duo as far as books and things that you're doing. Mm-hmm. I really wanted to have a conversation with you guys because I want to know how you do what it is that you're doing. When did you guys meet?
So this is, it's been over 2 years. One of my favorite places, and found out hers was Panera Bread. I used to like to go there to do writing and just kind of sit and chill out. So one day I went in and I was sitting and I kind of overheard her talking about some books. And then she signed a book and the person left. And it's like, So I went over and I said, excuse me, so you're a writer? And that's how the conversation went. I told her, you know, hey, I'm writing and thinking about put my first book out there, and we just started talking, and Tracee is a wealth of knowledge. She was instrumental in helping me with so much to get my first book off the ground, and we just started talking about, you know, things that are absent out here, mm-hmm. As far as support for writers and authors and how we can collaborate, and it just took off from there.
Wow. So Tracee, what was the first collaboration that you guys did? What was it like for you?
It was so much fun. Yeah. Last year we had a dual book release party, and it was so much fun. And when we had that party, and we brought both of our families there, our friends, and we said, you know what, we have to keep rolling with this. You know, and it's just nice to have someone that you can, you know, bounce ideas off of. And he's not a yes person. Mm-hmm. It's like I could send him a manuscript and he'll text me like, hey, I'm gonna call you. And I'm like, wait a minute, you know. And it's like, oh man, what chapter is he on? Like, what in the world? And so it's like, this is like my baby.
Right.
And it's like a kid coming home saying, you know, somebody messing with me. Right. Like, what messing with my baby? So, you know, he will give me his honest input, mm-hmm. and I know when I send him a book or ask him something, I know I'm getting a 100.
Right.
And you can't ask for better.
Right.
It's perfect.
And I think one of the things we realized too when we did that party is there just aren't a lot of events for authors, like mm-hmm. locally. If you go to Chicago or to some of the other like bigger cities like Los Angeles and New York, places like that, they have lots of different events for writers. We don't have a lot here, mm-hmm. And we decided, you know, let's put some things on the calendar and try to have some events, not only for for us, but for other authors, mm-hmm. where we can just kind of bring everyone together, because it's not, we don't look at it as a competition.
Right.
There are millions and millions of readers that can read just tons of books, and many readers have more than one favorite author.
Mm-hmm.
So just because you collaborate and do things together, it doesn't mean that your book sales are going to go down.
Exactly.
In fact, they can increase. So
those
are the types of things that we're looking at, and it could be fun. So
exactly.
You know, we're really enjoying the things that we're doing.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now, I had the pleasure of being at the dual book signing.
Yes.
And although I got there a little bit later, I could tell the energy in the room. It was a dynamic energy. People were purchasing books.
Yes,
people,
you
had different speakers that were there.
Yes.
And it was amazing. I thought it was amazing. The one thing that I know for sure is that when people of your caliber collaborate together, the event itself is something of a higher quality.
Mm.
What is it that you guys put into that event that made it so?
You know what, we wanted to our party to be relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted everyone to have a good time, so we put a lot of time into planning.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted great food, because to me, the food has to be on point. I come from a cooking family, so we had great food, we had great energy, our family, our friends, I mean, what more can you ask for?
Right.
And just to piggyback on what he was just talking about, you know, when we were looking for events, you know, to join or book clubs to join, it's not a lot in the Detroit area. So to me, in my opinion, if we can't find it, let's create it.
Right.
So that's what we're doing.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And that's awesome. So to be innovators as authors, what do you guys see outside of the fact that, you know, there's a lot of things that are not here in the city of Detroit? What do you see that needs to be here?
You know, one of the things, and I want to highlight that Sylvia Hubbard has a great group.
Mm-hmm.
And meeting Sylvia Hubbard and finding out about the group that she has opened up doors as well.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that we don't have is events where you can bring a large number of authors and writers together and their readers. Where you can sell books, you can talk about the industry, you can meet other writers, mm-hmm. editors, something of that caliber. You know, Chicago has a really big book show
mm-hmm.
Annually. We don't have anything on that scale. We have a few things that are in Detroit and some in some of the other outlying areas, but we would love to be able to have more specialized, localized events where we can get more authors together more often.
Okay. Well, we're going to take a break on that note. This is the Conversations with Kai Mann Show. I'm your host, Kai Mann, and we'll be right back.
One of the things I've dealt with was suicide, having thoughts of it and making attempts at it. I felt like I was a burden to others and had no reason to live. So I isolated myself by drinking, doing drugs, and becoming reckless. Did you know that after cancer and heart disease, suicide accounts for more years of life lost than any other cause of death? And even though men are more likely to die by suicide, women are more likely to attempt it. It wasn't until I rediscovered my passions and talents that my life changed. Look within. Get to your core. Join the movement. Hashtag get naked.
When we think about dynamic duos, we think about people who have collaborated or come together in business and in life. How has the meshing of your two styles come together and bring forth a better life for each of you?
I I think we complement each other a lot. In the book aspect of things, his writing, I love the way he writes. He writes thrill, suspense, and that's something that I've always wanted to dab into. Mm-hmm. So reading his books and helping him edit and things like that, it helps me. I learn from him. Mm-hmm. So it's a great duo. Because I just, you know, I kind of absorb what he's bringing to the table. So that's good for me.
The other thing is, so we both work. We have full-time jobs. We both have families. Mm-hmm. So single parents trying to raise families and working 40-plus hours a week and trying to find time to write. It's, you know, it could be trying sometimes. Mm-hmm. But we're able to bounce a lot off of each other, and as far as things that work well for her, where she's more efficient at doing things, those are things that I've been able to take from her and that have enabled me to be more productive. Mm-hmm. So we're able to bounce a lot off of each other because we're like going down like almost mm-hmm. the same path.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So, and you mentioned about him being a thrill or suspense writer. I have a couple of your books and I can't read them because I'm so scared. And I'm just being honest. I'm a little wimp. I'm gonna say that. I started reading one and I'm like, I'm gonna sit this right here just for a second, you know. But your writing is impeccable. You guys, the whole plaque king and queen thing to me is amazing.
Thank you.
You yourself, have written a number of books, mm-hmm. and I watch because I'm a kind of a stalker, so I kind of stalk people, you know. I'm not gonna lie, I stalk people, so I see what it is that you're doing, and I see the number of books that you're putting out into the universe, mm-hmm. and you're very methodical about what it is that you do. Can both Thank of you, you tell me about your methods and being methodical in your writing?
Yeah. So, I have this, I put together like this this storyboard of mm-hmm. things that I wanted to write about and themes and ideas. And for the most part, I've been able to go in line with that storyboard. Mm-hmm. But then I'll have an idea out of the blue. One day I'll wake up and it's something completely different. So mm-hmm. I veered from it with the last couple of titles. For me, I wanted to put together some nice, strong characters built on a foundation of intelligence and something that my kids could pick up and say, you know what, my dad wrote this book. Mm-hmm. And I've incorporated characters in my books based on my children. Wow. And based on my family, where, you know, many years from now, they can say, you know what, this character was based mm-hmm. on me, mm-hmm. and me putting into the book how I see them, so they can look at it and say, wow, this is how my dad sees me. And even though it's mm-hmm. fiction, there's a lot of truths hidden within that fiction.
I hear you. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And with me, with every book, I like to push myself mm-hmm. further and further. So, and I also like to tack on what's going on in the world, because mm-hmm. my last book, I like to take realistic situations and put the Tracee spin on it.
Yeah.
So with my last book, I kind of tapped on sex trafficking.
Mm-hmm.
That's unfortunately going on a lot now.
Right.
And so I love to take realistic situations and put that plot twist on it, and even divorce relationships. Friendships, but I've put my spin on it, and mm-hmm. I love for readers to read my books and say, you know what, that was me, or I had a friend like that, or, you know, I'm going through something, I can't put this book down, it's helping me. So I love to help people. It has an undertone of, I won't say self-help, but just mm-hmm. believing in yourself, having self-worth, so, but with a nice storyline to it, and that twist, it has to have a twist. So
I think it is self-help, and that. I think about this event that we did at Easter Market.
Okay.
And there was one person that was waiting for you to come back. You went to grab something to drink, or and when you had come back, she was waiting for you to get your book. Mm-hmm. And she was telling you how she had gone through divorce.
Yes,
and
I remember
something that happened in your book, she kind of went through the same thing, and how reading your book really helped to build her back up and pick herself up. Sometimes you can hear it, but then sometimes you read it and then it's something about it that just sticks.
Yes, I remember her. She's talking about disloyal. Yes. I love that.
It is self-help. And sometimes when you read a certain book, it may awaken something inside of you that you didn't know existed, or something that you needed at that particular time.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah. That's amazing. It's amazing to be able to help people in that way. And I believe that when people get together that are supposed to be together, in alignment as far as being, you know, dynamic in their own right and what they bring to the table of writing, I want to know, are you guys going to do something together? I think that would freaking be amazing.
Yes, this year you will see a book by Eugene and Tracee Boyd.
Awesome.
It's going to be ridiculous.
Is it?
Oh my goodness.
Ridiculous.
Okay. Well, we're going to talk about that when we come back.
Okay.
This is the Confirmations with Kai Mann Show. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Focus One Entertainment is Detroit's premier entertainment company. But we're not just an entertainment company. We are your number one multimedia resource. Focus One has combined years of talent and experience in order to bring you what you're looking for in a video. A polished professional product. F1 Entertainment specializes in filming workshops, seminars, and corporate presentations. More and more businesses are utilizing video production services to create web virtuals, online marketing content, and promotional and corporate training videos. Your company can do the same with Focus One Entertainment. Contact Focus One Entertainment at 313-444-3638 or visit us on the web at www.focusoneentertainment.com.
About this new book that you guys are coming out with. Come on, give us the goods. What is it about?
So, the book is, we plan to do something by the end of this year. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be written, and it's kind of difficult to give too much detail, but it's going to be written from two different perspectives. It's going to be written from It's going to be about a situation where this couple goes through something that is traumatic for both of them. But there's a reason why they're going through this traumatic episode, and it's not realized until towards the end of the book. So there are going to be these multiple perspectives, but then the way that we're going to be doing it, it's going to be like conversational, kind of like we're talking right now. Mm-hmm. But then it's going to be, we're going to be doing it like live. So we're going to actually be acting out a lot of the scenes in the book, and then going back and writing out what we just acted out. And we're going to also create it. It's going to be electronic, it's going to be paperback, and it's also going to be an audio book. And we're going to do the acting for the audio
book.
So it's going to be a nice mix, and we're going to pull out all the stops. It's going to be bananas.
Yeah. It's going to be crazy. And what we're going to try to do, we're not going to talk about it too much together. We're just going to have our storyline.
Right.
He's not going to know where I'm coming from and vice versa. So it's going to be like, whoa. So yeah.
Wow.
It's going to be ridiculous. I cannot wait for this.
I can't wait. So we're talking about like the beginning of next year, or?
It'll be the end of, probably the end of this year, sometime in December, like for a Christmas release.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you guys, you got this, I want to think, an empire that's beginning to build. I believe I see a foundation that's being poured. Where is it that you guys want to go as far as your collaboration, this dynamic duo? Where is it that you guys want to go?
We want to help people. When we met almost 2.5 years ago, we helped each other a lot. And we're not saying help is not out there, but we want to have twin pens as a company where someone can call us, email us, an aspiring writer, they need help, or storyline help, anything. We want to be the go-to people for that, you know? So, because I just love helping people. And the thing about it, just because you help someone, that doesn't dim your light.
Right.
Even though we're doing the same thing, I want to help you. I can learn from somebody else. Let's just all collectively do this and keep it moving. I mean, we can only grow from it. So I would love for us to be able to just help other writers and just keep building.
Yeah.
And it's another opportunity to put Detroit on the map as as a writer's haven. We're not the only two writers here in the city. There are tons of really good writers.
Yes.
And if there is something that we can do to help exploit the writers in a positive light, and the other programs that are out there, collaborate again to help build up you know, our city, I think that's ultimately where we would like to go. So we plan on doing more events.
Definitely.
We'll probably we're going to work on building this Twin Pens as our company. So we're going to work on building that name up, and there's going to be a lot that falls under that.
Right.
Eventually, we'd like to have our own publishing company.
Definitely.
So that will fall under Twin Pens, and we'll be bringing on new, aspiring, even experienced writers under our label.
Awesome. So you guys have come together, and in the aspects of coming together in everything that you do, there is always kind of your way of doing things and your way of doing things. Has there been an easy transition into meshing, or has it been, you know, a little rocky here and there, or just getting to understand each other's way of doing things?
I think we flow pretty good. The only thing, I mean, we're both very busy. We both work full time. Like he mentioned, we're both single parents.
The only thing? Oh, go ahead.
Really? I'm sorry. So, like I was saying, we are very busy. So we find time to, you know, make it work. And like, I just sent him my last book. Did you get that?
I did. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay. So I just sent him a book yesterday. So I know he's going to read it, edit, but he's so busy. I mean, he works 7 days a week. So, I mean, we just make it work. And I think we mesh well because we respect we respect what the other is doing, but we still get the job done.
Awesome.
So it's pretty cool.
And we have some of our ideas, you know, are kind of all over the place. Sometimes I'll come from an entirely different perspective, but then it blends well.
Yes.
So there are some things that we are completely opposite on. If you think about writing, like with the things that she likes to write about and how she writes, and I'll pick something that I have no knowledge of, but you know, I want to put a story together like this, and I'll like the book I'm currently working on, I had to study the Quran a great deal and learn about things in order to intelligently write about it.
Right.
So, you know, I'm like the wild card, and she's more conservative. Mm-hmm. But it works when we come together.
Awesome.
So just imagine my face when he told me about this new book. I'm like, you're what? With the Quran? Now I have to get up on my stuff. Slow down. Like, what else is coming up? My goodness, I mean, he pushing it.
Well, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. This is the Conversations with Kai Mann Show.
Hello, Detroit, and welcome to the Secret Society of Twisted Storytellers, where real people tell true stories live on stage. No notes, no poetry, or Dr. Seuss, just the truth from their lips to your listening hearts and minds. Stories so raw and revealing, so hilarious, human, and healing, they will move and inspire you. Take a break from what you usually do. Come out, connect, meet old friends and new every third Friday at the Charles H. Wright Museum of African American History. Visit www.secretstorytellers.com to watch videos and for info and tickets today.
One of the things that I've dealt with was depression. Feelings of sadness and loneliness from what I used to have. Most of us feel depressed at times, that's normal. But when it lasts more than 2 weeks and it begins to interfere with your daily activities like work, school, or taking care of the kids, that's when you should talk to a professional. 3-5% of most people suffer from depression. It wasn't until I addressed what was going on inside of me, instead of suppressing it, that my life changed. Talk to someone. You matter. Join the movement. Hashtag get naked.
With new books, with wanting to have a publishing company, with wanting to help other people, coaching other authors, working 40 hours, working 7 days a week, you know, having a family that, you know, you guys separately you take care of and you're managing your life. Mm-hmm. What is the one thing that you can say in this dynamic duo that brings probably the most joy out of what it is that you guys do?
I love seeing his face when he drops the book, when he releases a book. I'm so happy for him because I can think back to when he told me about the idea. Mm-hmm. And just writing is a job in itself. So it makes me so happy for him when he releases a book because I know what he went through to get that out there. You know, I mean, he's a busy person. He stays up late writing. So I'm just so happy for him. And I mean that, yeah. Very happy.
And then she's really humble. Yes, I'm busy. I will admit it. I am busy. But, you know, again, we're both single parents. And you're talking about coming home and cooking and washing and cleaning and running kids around and doing all of these things.
Uber driver.
And you still have to find time. And you find time for things that matter most to you. Mm-hmm. For me, is being able to do all of these things and still be able to find time to write and find time to release and not letting things fall apart, keeping it all together. Because it is hard. And I know that we both, and I can speak for Tracee in saying that if we could write full time, and that's a goal, that would be phenomenal.
Right.
Because it's something that we both love to do, we both enjoy it. But there are some other obligations that we have to contend with, and you know, maybe eventually we'll be there.
Yeah. So in all of that, having said all of that, how do you as a dynamic duo, but also as individual people, how do you find the balance for yourselves? How do you when is it that you take that time, that mental time, or that mental space just for yourself so that you can, you know, continue to be the mom, continue to write the books, you know, continue to be the dad, continue to work 7 days a week? You know, how do you find that time for yourself so that you're balanced? And,
you know, I'm going to have to be honest to say that for me, that's, that can be difficult because I wake up typically between 6 and 6:30 in the morning, and I go to bed 12 to 12:30 at night, and I try to cram as much as I can into it and into the day, and I'm working 7 days, and sometimes I'll just reach a point where it's like, you know, I gotta take a break, and I'll take a day off. If it's a half a day, or just take a day off, and it's not that I go anywhere. Sometimes I'll sit and I have my laptop, I have my feet propped up, and I'm just happy, and there's peace and quiet in the house. And it's like heaven.
Or I don't get a text message telling him, hey, I hope you're relaxing.
I don't do it enough. I will admit that's a balance for me, finding personal time, because I sacrifice a lot of it for, you know, my family and friends sometimes. And I'm okay with that, because I know that eventually I'll get there. I'm not quite there yet, though.
You know, for me, once my day has started, it's just going. So I'm an early riser, so I may get up before everybody just to enjoy my peace, think about my books, just be in my peace. So I make sure I get up before the kids and not make a sound, because if they hear me, then they're up. So it's like, okay, I can't get out of bed. Let me just sit here and just relax. So I try to wake up before my kids just to have some time to myself. So I know once we get up, that's just it.
What is it that you guys could share with other even authors or even people who are entrepreneurs in business wanting to come together to collaborate on something such as a publishing company? What could you offer them? Like, what can you give them that would help them?
I would say be tenacious, have thick skin, know who you can trust, and don't stop. Just keep pushing forward. You're not going to please everybody. That's something I had to learn, you know, with book reviews and things like that. Just keep pushing forward. You have to believe in what you're doing. Because if you don't believe it, how do you expect the next person to? So have self-confidence and keep it moving forward.
And I think another thing is not to assume that an idea that you have might not work. We put everything on the table, no matter what the idea is. We put it out there, and then you'd be surprised that at times you may come up with something that would actually work, where it may seem like this the craziest thing, and it works. So share. Don't be afraid. Don't hold back. Share your knowledge, your wisdom,
definitely,
your ideas. And, you know, to Tracee's point, everything's not going to appeal and work, and you have to have thick skin to realize that, hey, that's okay. Be able to critique and be able to accept having your work and your ideas critiqued. I think that has allowed us to be successful so far.
We're going to take a quick break. This is the Conversations with Kai Mann Show. I'm your host, Kai Mann. We'll be right back.
Focus. The state or quality of having or producing clear definition. Focus One Entertainment is the premier videography company in the Midwest. We specialize in weddings, corporate events, documentaries, sporting events, and films. Regardless of the scope or budget, we approach every project the same way, by capturing and clearly defining your vision. Contact us at 313 313- 844-3638 or www.focusoneentertainment.com.
With life, we as entrepreneurs, we earlier you stated about having, you know, tough skin. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we're told no. Sometimes we're told that that's not going to work. How have you guys been able to deal with that? When you've been told no, when you've been told that that idea sucks or is not going to work, how have you been able to come back from that, or not even go anywhere, but to be able to still move forward from that?
Oh, with me, I just keep in the back of my mind, again, you can't please everybody. And it's easier said than done. I mean, the first time I had a 1-star review on Amazon, I was like, what? I mean, my feelings were just on the floor.
Yeah.
But I have to realize, I mean, it's thousands on top of thousands of people out here reading. I mean, really, everyone's not going, I'm not going to please everyone. So, and that's fine with me because I put my best into my work. So as long as I know that, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If I know I did my very best, I'm good with it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What about you, H.U.G.?
Well, I guess it's kind of to her point. There's certain things that you can control and certain things that you can't. Thinking about my work, for instance, and talking about publishing, so I self-publish. One of the advantages is if I have an idea, even if it may not be what's hot in the market right now, if it's something that I want to go with, I can go with it. But there have been times where I've come to Tracee and bounced the title off of her, and I was really excited about this title. And she gave me a million ways why it just wasn't a good title, or especially my book covers, because I design my own book covers.
Mm-hmm.
And I sometimes end up sending her like 12 drafts because I like the first one and, well, you might want to do this or do this, and it's like, I don't want to do it. But then I think about it. You know, I take what the advice that she gives, I take a step back and I look at it and say, you know what, yeah, she's right. Yeah, let me change this, and it does make a world of difference.
So I'm glad you brought that up, because sometimes we have an ego.
Mm-hmm.
We can look at something and we like it, mm-hmm. and we feel like it's that deal, it's that thing that's
right.
gonna take us to
right.
that next level. And when someone else takes a look at it and they, you know, come back with something totally different than what you said, how hard has it been for you to be able to accept that type of criticism, you know, and you know, from the beginning? You know, because sometimes now in the end you can say, well, I know that whatever it is that she's telling me is the best thing. But in the beginning, the first time that she did that, how was your ego at that particular space?
When you just have poured hours and days, weeks, months, maybe even years into something with the very best of intentions, and you try to think about multiple people and perspectives, and yeah, this is it. And then you put it out there, and it's like, it's okay.
What you talking
what
about?
What do you mean it's okay? It's
Stop
just
it.
Okay.
No.
And it was hard because you see things in a certain way or fashion, it doesn't mean that other people do.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess that's the beautiful thing about writing. You can have 20 different people pick up the book, and they interpret something different
mm-hmm.
from the story.
Absolutely.
And their interpretation may be completely different from what was intended when you wrote it.
Right.
It's kind of like poetry.
Yeah.
You know, when I write poetry, I don't say what I meant by it. I let you decide what it means to you,
mm-hmm.
and run with it from there. But yeah, the criticism can be tough.
It's hard.
It, my feelings were hurt, and mm-hmm. it was like, okay,
yeah.
I guess this is the part of it that you're also supposed to look forward to,
mm-hmm.
because it's not somebody that's just saying yes.
Right, right.
And that's what I like. He's not a yes person. And I remember I sent him a book, and it took him a few days because, I mean, the turnaround is just out of sight. He'll send it right back. So when he sent it back and I opened it, I'm like, what is all this red? I'm like, red. So I had to collect myself and just, I mean, he wants the best for me, and I know that, but...
Right.
You just, I'm like, what is all these markings? I mean, this book was popping right. when I sent it. So I'm like, okay, red. I gave him a sad ass for a minute, but I know he wants, you know, what's best for me. So
right. I asked that question because, you know, in everything that we do, and it's amazing to be able to have someone to bounce things off of and mm-hmm. to give that second or third look. But it also can be sometimes, you know, disheartening. Mm-hmm. And I know for my own self, because of the fact of, you know, I'm the bomb, you know,
right.
and that to have someone to take a look at something, even I had to really begin to grow in that particular space and be, you know, able to say, well, they, you know, they're looking at it from the angle of they want the best for me. Mm-hmm. And you have to be able to grow in that space. You guys growing in that space, how have you been able to grow in that particular space?
Well, for me, I go back a few books and I see, you know, where I started.
Mm-hmm.
And I take his criticism and constructive criticism, and I just grow from it. I say, okay, I see what he's talking about. You have to be open.
Right.
When you give someone your work, you have to be open. And like he was talking about with the covers, like with him, he may say, well, you know what? Because I love plot twists.
Mm-hmm.
He may say, I saw that coming.
Mm-hmm.
And see, with me writing, I'm like, oh, this is about to be the bomb. They don't know what's going on. And he may say, well, you know what? I kind of peeped that out. So it's helping me grow more because I'm looking at it from a different standpoint.
Right.
So.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
With me, I can honestly say with each book, I see myself grow. And criticism or critiques that I got from earlier books, as I got further into writing, mm-hmm. they make more sense to me now. Mm-hmm. Where I understand, it's like, okay, I understand what they were talking about
mm-hmm.
now.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes sense. Not all criticism is warranted, but I've taken a lot of things that I've learned and incorporated into my work. A lot of the advice that she's given and I've gotten from others is helped to make me a better writer, and I'm able to see it the more that I write,
mm-hmm.
How much sense that it makes.
Okay. And we're going to take a quick break. This is the Conversations with Kai Mann Show. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
assume, in the grand scope of writing, when I look at who you are as people, as individuals, but then as a collective, I see that there is such a power that is emitted between the two of you. There is probably a number of people that are dynamic in what it is that they do. But the mere fact that you guys stand your ground, the mere fact that you're consistently marketing yourselves, because I see it. Mm-hmm. I've been stalking you guys for a while. So I see it. What have been some of the issues maybe that you see in marketing yourselves and promoting yourselves?
It takes time. Mm-hmm. But you have to be consistent and you have to be tenacious about it. It's like you can't drop in on Facebook Tuesday, here's my book, and then come back next month. You have to be consistent, and that's what we try to do. And sometimes we may make a schedule, okay, let's do this, I know he uses different, is it Hootsuite and mm-hmm. things like that, but mm-hmm. we try to be consistent. We don't want to overdo it, mm-hmm. but you kind of have to stay out there. And with me, I'm trying to venture out a little bit. I'm doing blogging now. Mm-hmm. So if they love my blog, and they'll probably buy my books, you know? Right. So, you know, you do different little things like that. He puts a lot of quotes out there. People love his quotes,
yeah.
Inspirational quotes. So that in turn, they'll say, wow, I love his uplifting spirit. Mm-hmm. Let me check out his book. So it goes hand in hand. So you just put yourself out there and you have to be consistent.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's, trying to figure out the right formula for marketing. So, is it Twitter? Is it Facebook? Mm-hmm. Is it Instagram? Is it Pinterest? Mm-hmm. Do you blog? And then trying to find time for everything. The consistency is the key to it. Mm-hmm. So, I think it's easy to get bogged down on trying to be on everything. Mm-hmm. You don't have to be.
Right.
Pick one or two formats and just try to be consistent with them. And, you know, do you pay for ads? Do you not pay for them? It's a lot that goes into it. And there's a lot of experimentation. We've mm-hmm. experimented with probably just about everything
yes.
out there.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, the consistency piece is what can be tough, especially when we're working during some of the peak hours that people are out there.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's why applications like Hootsuite and other type of schedulers and things like that can help.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, again, it's just the whole consistency piece of it and trying to stay on top of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I see you guys and what it is that you're doing, and you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
You really are. You're doing a great job. I see your quotes. I see the plot twist and how you are consistently using that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a good deal.
Thank you.
That's a really good deal. Yes. I see that. I foresee, because I have this intuition, mm-hmm. that the two of you are going to be not only just powerful here in the city of Detroit, I see that you will be powerful across the country.
Thank you. Continue in
what it is that you're doing.
Absolutely.
Continue in doing that.
Thank you so much.
You guys, as a dynamic duo, what you're doing works. It really does.
It works.
Yes. It works. I have a tendency to sit back and I'm a quiet person. Mm-hmm. No, you guys can't tell it here on the conversation show, but I'm a quiet person. And that's because I not so much to study people, but I sit and I pay attention to people and what it is that they do. And a lot of times on a day-to-day basis, because I want to see the consistency, I want to mm-hmm. see what it is that you're doing and how it's working. And I want to see, you know, people come together and it just bloom. And you guys are doing just that.
Thank you.
I met you probably about 2 years ago when I interviewed you for the Motown Writers Network.
Yes.
And it was an amazing interview then.
Thank you.
I remember at that particular time, though, you had told me that it had taken you a long time to write your book.
Mm-hmm.
And since then, Since then, and I like to see that you've been like just pumping them out. And what for you made you switch? Like, what was that light that came on for you to say, you know, it took me however long that first book, 10 years, to now it's going to be every 6 months or every year that I'm pumping out a book.
Once I reached the end of that first book, I was having so much fun. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you know what, this is where I should have been. I should have did this a long time ago. Mm-hmm. And I had so many ideas, and I still have, I got a lot in this head of mine. Mm-hmm. Let's get it on paper. Yeah. And I have just been going. And on average, it usually takes me about 3 to 4 months to write a book. And I could write something sooner, but I like to do a lot of research and mm-hmm. try to take my time. But I'd usually come out with a book every 4 months. Mm-hmm. And I probably have ideas in my head right now for at least 8 more books. But things change. Tomorrow, something will happen. I'll see something. It's like, I got to write about that. Mm-hmm. And they may take precedence over everything else that I had mm-hmm. in the pipeline. But that's how it goes. I'm really enjoying it, what I'm doing. So
amazing. Mm-hmm. Amazing. So for you, has there, and I didn't know the Tracee before because I didn't get to interview you as well.
Right.
So I don't know what prior to that, like what your writing style was. So from mm-hmm. where it is that you've gone from 2 years ago, because I did meet you.
Yes.
So from that particular space mm-hmm. until today, what's different about Tracee the writer?
I have grown so much. And now I'm starting to, I would say, I like to call my writing style the gumbo. Mm. I throw everything in the book. I don't want to be in one genre. Mm-hmm. And so I think from when we first met, I'm starting to push myself more. Mm-hmm. I'm starting to go more into the thriller lane, suspense lane. Mm-hmm. So I'm driving all over the place now instead of one lane. So the car is all over the place now. So I'm growing.
Great. So you just forego that whole stay in your lane thing. You
I'll
make your own lane.
I'm in Tracee's lane and I'm all over the freeway.
All right, so. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, what I'd like for you guys to do is to each of you talk about your books, your latest book, where it is that you're going next, and as a company together, where you guys are going next, and how we can find you.
Great. I just finished a book. It's titled Summer's Night Part 2. Mm-hmm. Real quick, it's about two sisters. They live in Detroit summer and Sunday. They lost their parents. Mm. They're just trying to make it. Her little sister has special needs, and she meets a man named Knight. And she thinks, wow, this is the light at the end of the tunnel, but he brings more darkness.
Wow.
So that will be released next month. And we have a big event coming up, but we'll talk about that after H&G.
So I have one book that was just released. It's been about a month and a half ago. It's called Linda's Closet. It is a drama / suspense thriller. It's about the character Linda Chambers, and her life is falling apart, her marriage, she's losing her kids, but that's not the only thing that she's about to lose. It takes her 5 doctors and 3 hospital visits to find something deep within that, if she doesn't figure out how to address it, is certainly going to kill her.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Now, I also have my first short story that's going to be released actually next week. It's called Orange Slices, and on the cover of the book, it is orange slice candy, mm-hmm. and the story is about a guy named Paul who has a bag of orange slices, and it's what he has to do with these orange slices that creates a very unique end in this book.
Wow.
You're going to love it. He calls me one day. He says, hey, where can I buy orange slices? I said, what is this man working on now? I'm like, here we go. So just wait.
Great. So tell us as a company where you guys are headed.
We want to mentor more people. We're going to have more events coming up. And like he stated earlier, our ultimate goal is to have a publishing company. But we just want to work with more writers and join just as many book clubs as we can, help people, and just continue to grow as writers ourselves.
Okay. So where can we find each of you?
I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and IG, Tracee the Writer, and it's T-R-A-C-E-E, or Tracee Boyd on Facebook.
And I'm H. Eugene Writes on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I'm also on Pinterest. And Pinterest is a great place for everything. Mm-hmm. So I'm also on Pinterest. And my website is www.inkthriller.com.
Okay. All righty.
Yes.
I thank you guys for being on the show.
We thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I look forward to seeing more.
Absolutely.
It's coming. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate your support.
Thank you. This has been Conversations with Kai Mann. Good night.